Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we'll be learning about a new function called JSON underscore equal. This function is newly introduced from Oracle 18c version onwards. Prior to 18c version, in case if you want to compare two JSON document, typically we used to extract the information from each JSON document, then we can compare the information side by side, either by writing a query to extract and compare the information on the fly, or either extracting the information and then populate the information into a table, then write a query on top of that to check whether the data sets of both JSONs are equal or not. Or in fact, we can go and write a PLSQL function or a procedure which can extract this information and again compare and return back whether the given JSON is equal or not. But from it, the problem of all these approaches are something like the complexity of the logic, whatever we need to write, will increase with the complexity of the JSON. If it is a quite straightforward and a simple JSON, we can easily extract and compare it. However, if there is a quite a complex JSON with consists of like nested array objects and nested array of JSON document, then it is quite difficult to extract and compare. So from 18c, Oracle provides a new function called JSON underscore equal, which takes two string data containing a JSON document, and Oracle will compare these two JSON and returns the information. Let us learn through the key points of this JSON equal function through few examples. Here is our first use case. So here I am using the JSON underscore equal in the case statement. Since the JSON equal will return a boolean, I am checking if it is true, I am printing as the same JSON. In case if it returns false, I am printing something like a different JSON. So here I am trying to compare two simple empty JSON, one JSON with just a open and closed curly braces. However, the second JSON has few white characters, just to check whether this is returning same or not. In this case, Oracle will return same because Oracle will not bother about the white spaces or the formatting of the data in the JSON. However, it will check only the name and the value pair. It doesn't bother whether it is in the same order or not. It will just check whether the same name value pair exists in both the number of name value pair and the data of the name value pair should match. Let us check our second use case. So here is the second use case. I am trying to compare two JSON document, one with a null value, another with an empty string. Oracle will in fact return false. It will say that it cannot compare a null with an empty, so it obviously will return a different JSON. So the same case, you cannot compare with empty from one side and of a null of other side. In fact, this also will return different. Okay. However, we can compare an empty string with an empty string, something like this. So this will return as the same JSON. The same thing holds good. We can compare for a null value with another null value. So here also it will return the same JSON. Let us check our next use case. So here is the third use case. I am trying to compare two JSON document which is exactly the same. So obviously it will return as the same JSON document. So there is no doubt in this case. So here is the fourth use case. I am trying to compare two JSON document. One side it is a uppercase name. However, for the second JSON it is a lowercase name. So Oracle will check for exactly the same case. However, it will not check the order, but the case of the name part and the value part should exact case as well as the data should exactly the match. There should not be any white space within the value part. For example, here the Scott is exactly the same, so it has written same JSON. However, if you put a space, white space within the value part or a name part, it will be different. It will be treated as a different. However, we can have any number of white space outside this name value pair part. So these white spaces are ignored. However, the white space within the name portion or within the value portion will not be ignored. It will be considered for comparison. Let us check our next use case. So here is another JSON data set comparison. So here in one side I have an employee ID and an employee name information. In the second JSON also I have a same thing like employee name and employee ID. However, the order of this name value attributes are different. However, Oracle will compare and say that these two JSONs are exactly same. As I already mentioned, the key rules for comparison are the number of attributes should match, the name value pair should exactly match, and there should not be any space difference or there should not be any case difference between them. If all these things has matches, it will return true. Let us check our next use case. So here is another JSON. Here I have taken an array of number for comparison. So I have in one JSON, I have a number list from 1 to 6. Same way in the second JSON also, I have a same data set. Obviously, this will return same because both the arrays are exactly same. However, if there is any change in the order of array, Oracle will say that they are different JSON. Let us see that information through another use case. See, here I have two array information. In the first JSON, I have an array value from 1 to 6. However, in the second JSON, I have the array value from 6 to 1. In this case, Oracle will return these two things are different. So within the array, the order matters. However, within the JSON document, the order of attribute doesn't matter. However, within the array, the order should exactly match. Otherwise, Oracle will throw that, say that these two are different JSON document. Now, whatever the use cases I have showed you till now, I'm just populating into a table so that we can check this information as part of the WHERE class. Okay, the same data set, whatever I have showed in the earlier examples, I'm just populating into a table. So I'm creating a simple table called JSON_sample_data_table, where I have two column, one column called JSON1, where I'm storing the first JSON information, another column called JSON2, where I'm storing the another set of JSON information. I'm just using a check constraint here, just to make sure that whatever the information we are inserting into this table is a valid JSON document. Okay. I'm just executing this so that let this table get created. Yeah, table got created. All the rows are inserted and the statement is submitted. Okay. Now, let me just query from the table. Okay. Now we are able to see all the information. The value for JSON1, JSON2, in fact, all this information.
Now we'll use the JSON_equal function in WHERE condition.
Now if you see, in fact, the JSON2, whatever is in the row 1 will have a space. When it is printing, it is just formatting and it is printing. That's why we are not able to see the white space here. However, both are same. That's why it is just printing the JSON, whatever is matching, whatever exactly matches. The second case, we are matching with an empty string, That's why it is displayed. In the fourth row, wherever the serial number is 4, we are comparing with a null value, Fifth row is exactly the same, Scott is Scott. Sixth and seventh are the same JSON document. However, in the seventh, for seventh serial number, the orders are different. So the order of attribute doesn't matter. However, the order within the array matters. That's why we are seeing the eighth JSON is exactly same. So let us check like WHERE not JSON equal. That means this will print whatever the JSON that doesn't matches. So we can see here the row number 2, that is serial number 2, we are trying to compare with a null with an empty string, that's why it is not matching. Same way for serial number 9, the order of array information doesn't match with the array list in the second JSON. Just to summarize our learning, there are few key rules for JSON equal function to return a true or false. One is that it will ignore the white spaces, as we see here. Again, a null value has to be compared with another null value only. It cannot be compared with the empty string. So this will return a false. So as I mentioned, empty string can be compared with the empty string. So in this case, it returns true. So this is exactly the same. So that's why it is returned true. So here the data set exactly matches. That's why it is returned true. Here the data set exactly matches. However, the order of attribute differs. So that is not an issue for within a JSON document. That's why it is true. Here the order matches exactly. That's why it is returned true. However, the array order doesn't match with the array order here. That's why it is returned false. Thank you for watching. Please share your comments.